Folks, welcome back to Game 4 of the Krumpin Kup Finals. And, you know, I'll probably show some other matches from the Krumpin Kup, too, just to make sure some of the players get highlighted, even those who didn't make the finals. You can see the army picks here. I'll cover them in some detail as we get in. I am about to state the current score of this matchup. It is a best of five, so if you haven't watched the other battles, I'm giving you a chance right now to stop, pause, go watch the other ones. All right, so we do stand at 2-1 Pugginton coming into game four. This is a High Elves versus Skaven matchup. This is actually a pretty interesting matchup. The Skaven definitely have a lot of tools for dealing with certain types of High Elf threats, but at the same time, the High Elves have, in my opinion, decent tools for dealing with Skaven. Now, I don't play a ton of competitive multiplayer, so there may be slightly differing opinions, but at least just kind of at a social and kind of lower level type of play, both factions have some good tools to hurt each other. Now, again, when we're in this competitive rule set that I'm less familiar with, it's quite possible that that matchup is heavily in favor of one of these or the others, and I'm sure that the more competitive players watching will probably leave some comments on it and give you their thoughts. But let's get things going here. There's a couple of Shadow Warriors. Now, these are units that can stalk, meaning they can approach the enemy unseen, and then open fire from pretty long range, 180 range. There's one of those coming up either flank, and the Skaven have been firing with their Plague Claw catapults into some Illyrian Reavers. Remember, Pugginton is the High Elves, and Odium Chosen One is playing as Lord Skrulk and the Skaven. You can see we do have Teclis leading the battle. He's got Chain Lightning and Fiery Convocation, Potion of Choroi, probably the Sword of Teclis too. Yeah. He's not on the Arcane Phoenix. I don't know if it was actually against the rules. In case you all haven't seen, there's actually a video out by Milk and Cookies Total War right now, or Indie Pride, where he's basically trying to say that there's a certain army that's just broken, and I think he has a few fair points with it. Teclis and his Arcane Phoenix is extremely powerful. And it's an odd decision by CA to give him that type of buff, but whatever. Here we are. This is regular Teclis, not the new Super Teclis. And honestly, regular Teclis is pretty good when used properly. Look at this, Natty Bubo's Sharpshooters. This is a Warplock Gazelle, long range, nice damage. They just wrecked one of the few High Elf Spearmen who are on the field, and that's kind of a big deal because those Spearmen need to provide protection for the archers. Plague Claw Catapults are devastating, all the way from long to shorter range against infantry and skirmishers on foot. Very good artillery pieces and a good choice versus the High Elf, as he's going to need to kill some of both, probably, whenever facing them. There are two Hellpit Abominations. This is probably to help ward off single entity monsters or cavalry, and there is indeed cavalry in this case. You see the Rat Ogres charging in against the Spearmen and Dragon Princes. There's a couple of Dragon Princes throughout the battlefield. Skrulk is going to be using some summons to help shore up the middle of this army. And then he's running his Clan Rats forward and his Skaven Slaves to chase enemy archers. This is a good choice. You can see he just bypasses the Spearmen. Fiery Convocation missed its mark here, but the Dragon Princes did not miss their mark. They killed one of the Plague Claw Catapults. The other Plague Claw Catapult just routed, but the High Elves are suffering some losses in return, with their archers taking a fair bit of damage. Now, as far as the leadership for the Skaven, you've got Skrulk and an Assassin. You can see Skrulk, he obviously can summon Clan Rats. He's already done that. He just summoned Plague Monks. He's also got the Rod of Corruption and the Liber Bubonicus, which means that he'll be able to cause direct damage to infantry blobs, or just blobs in general, and single entities. And so Skrulk, with the combination of this Assassin, who is also carrying, I think, trophy. Yeah, Assassin's Trophy and Rival Hide Talisman, is going to make it really difficult. This army from the Skaven is really well built for dealing with a High Elf Goon Squad, honestly. It's got long range, which is the Natty Bubo Sharpshooters, to contend with those. See another Chain Lightning here dropped by Teclis, who's trying to clean up the skirmishing capability of the Skaven. But the skirmishing capability of the Skaven is only one facet of the danger the High Elves are facing, and I'm sure Pugginton is well aware of this. He's got to deal with this Assassin, he's got to deal with Skrulk, and when Skrulk is around any of these other single entities, like the Hellpit or the Assassin, it's going to be really difficult for the High Elves to kill them, based on the units they have here. You can see here there's a desperation attempt to get rid of the Natty Bubo's sharpshooters, and probably appropriately so. This unit is extremely dangerous. You can see the Dragon Princes trying very hard to get rid of them. Some of the archers who were being chased by clan rats and Skaven slaves have now been freed up and are being brought back, though when they take damage, they lose ammunition. Every unit model that dies takes its ammunition with it. This isn't like the old Total Wars, where if you have one archer left, he gains all the ammunition of his fallen comrades. It becomes a little different. In fact, this game in general is very different in the sense that sometimes winning a skirmish will be absolutely key. Sometimes you can win a skirmish and still lose the battle. Whereas in older Total War games, it was not always certain, but fairly certain that if you gave up the skirmish, you were going to lose the battle. You're going to get ripped apart by these units in the end. And Warhammer is just very different because of the unit variety. The different infantry units, like the Skaven, for instance, their infantry has pretty good speed, and they can run down skirmishers on foot. It makes them kind of unique in that sense. They have terrible infantry from a defense, armor, attack standpoint. Their infantry is just gosh awful. But the Skaven have a ton of units that can actually run down enemy skirmishers on foot. And they can keep a decent pace, which makes it even frustrating for cavalry. But they're also terribly weak to heavy cavalry. You can see that with the Dragon Princes punishing all this infantry. With their low armor and not so great defense and lack of armor piercing, units like Dragon Princes will just run roughshod all over Skaven infantry. And you can see that that's what's happening here. There's continued attempts here with the Chain Lightning and the Fiery Convocation, and some of them are landing some damage and getting some work done. So Teclis working hard to give his forces a fighting chance. So another thing to make you all aware of here, I'm going to drop this so you can get a bit more cinematic view. The Hellpit Abominations regenerate. So if you're not familiar with this game, Hellpit Abominations will regenerate their health slowly over time. And so any moment that you've done a ton of damage to this, but you're not actually killing it, is really reversing the damage that you've done. And then that's really bad because it can reverse its hit points, but you can't reverse the ammunition on your archers. So when you do get a Hellpit Abomination low, you kind of have to finish it, or else you're going to end up paying a high price for not having done so. And it's easier said than done sometimes, obviously. You've got all these archers who are looking to come over here and try and finish one of these Hellpit Abominations. See them moving this way, the other one now being targeted. At this point, the High Elves really have their work cut out for them. Teclis is not on his Phoenix. He's not going to be able to just come in here and Zerg Lord Skrulk. Skrulk could still have his Lieber, is it Lieber Bubonicus, I believe, that does the damage to the single entity. And if Teclis gets anywhere close to that, he's going to take massive damage. And not only that, these Hellpit Abominations are going to rip Teclis a new one really quickly in melee. Like I said, this is not the Teclis on Arcane Phoenix with his absurd damage capabilities. This is Teclis on a horse as we once knew him. And he's just a totally different lord in that scenario. He's got a good enfeebling foe here on the Hellpit, but the Hellpit's going to flee, so this is a good decision by Chosen One. Try to avoid combat, and you can actually see he's doing a pretty good job of dodging arrows here too, as best you can when your target is literally like the broadside of a barn with the Hellpit Abominations. So we're going to see a lot of effort here from the High Elf Archers to kill these Hellpit Abominations, and rightly so. They're definitely a huge threat. Honestly, though, at this point, even with the Hellpit Abominations dead, I'm questioning whether the High Elves could cut through Skrulk if he still has a Rod of Corruption, because as soon as they blob up trying to kill him, he's just going to hit them with the Rod of Corruption and melt them or put some summons on them. Skrulk is one of my favorite Skaven Lords, probably my favorite Skaven Lord, just in the sense that he's not a melee beast, but he's a real damage sink, right? You get people in close to him, and he can cause a ton of damage, even though it's not necessarily just via his defense or attack skills, right? Which he's not terrible, he's not great, but Skrulk isn't terrible in terms of those stats. You can see it here, he's actually got pretty good weapon strength and nice melee attack, just not armor piercing. And so Skrulk is really an interesting Skaven Lord. Again, he tends to be probably my favorite just in terms of what he brings to the battlefield for the Skaven. He can add a lot of units, which is important because as the Skaven, your infantry sucks. So having more of them is never a bad thing. See him prancing through here, and then the arrows continue to go after it. Look at that very nice dodging by Chosen One. and the Hell Pit Abominations, and the Skrulk, of course, getting knocked around by the Illyrian Reavers, but no appreciable damage from a unit like Illyrian Reavers. And here you can see all those units collide, and they're going to get, I do believe they're taking, yeah, they're getting hit by Errata Corruption. So see, this is exactly what I expected. As soon as things clobber in trying to kill these units, Skrulk hits them with Errata Corruption, dishes out massive damage, starts to unleash the summons, and the summons are going to be brutal at this point in the game. The High Elves really don't have a lot to contend with all these Plague Monks and other units very well. Teclis is going to swoop in, and he's going to have to be careful because he could very well get hit with a Lever Bubonicus at this point. Is that a potion of... Yeah, it looked like the Potion of Troy. Yeah, it was on Skrulk for a moment. Yeah, that was on Teclis. He's trying to heal, and you can see he's got the Rival Hide Talisman right now, which means his attack is zero. So that's very helpful when you're trying to kill something. So yeah, attacking Skrulk is difficult. It takes the right moment, and the help hits are a nice synergy with Skrulk and this assassin. Huge debuffing, huge damage, regeneration. So again, all very nice synergies. I really like the pick from the Skaven here. The Plague Claw Catapults are going to be great against High Elf range and infantry. And honestly, they'll do decent against cavalry if the cavalry doesn't dodge too hard. You know, you can occasionally get hits on cavalry. Natty Bubo's sharpshooters are absolutely devastating to single entity. And then the Skrulk, of course, with his Lieber Bubonicus. And then the Rivalhide Talisman, Assassin Trophy. And then combine that with the Hell Pits. It's a big danger for any dragon or phoenix or anything else that wants to swoop in. And from a cavalry standpoint, you can see that the cavalry for the High Elves did great. But without the single entity monsters, it gets really hard to fight the Skaven single entity monsters, unless you're lucky enough to have your bows put down one of these targets. And honestly, Pugginton's been working hard at this, and both of the Hell Pit Abominations have taken some serious damage. And he's done a really good job. In fact, one of them's down to, it looks like it's about to die, even though it has 1,000 hit points. So sometimes looks can be deceiving on these things. And you can see there it actually picked up a heal. That's one of the abilities that the help hits come with. It just picked up a save and picked up 2,000 hit points when the combat got going. And so help hit abominations are just a massive damage sink. And unless you have the right tools to KO them quickly, they just get really nasty as the fight draws on. And then, like I said, combine that with the assassin and Skrulk in here. Skrulk, I think, has a leadership debuff on units that he attacks. It's gruesome. Yeah, look right here, contaminated, so minus 10 leadership. So Teclis is going to put up a great fight. This battle, though, clearly is going to roll in favor of ODM Chosen One, and that's honestly going to be pretty cool for all of us, because that means that this best of five is going all the way to game five, and we have a 2-2 tie 4 games into this, so going to have a really good time watching this. Now, hey, good news, by the way. If you go check out, I'm going to link a video on demand for the live stream of this, and YouTube has finally fixed it to where you can see all 5 hours and 45 minutes of it, which means that you can go watch game one from the series now. It's one that we didn't have the replay for, so I couldn't show it here. And you could watch it on your phone or your tablet. It was working on mobile, but for some reason YouTube had it screwed up to where only the last 2 hours of the event was available, and so it was making it where you couldn't see Battle 1, but you can now see it even on browser on PC, because YouTube got their crap together, I guess. I mean, look at the kills on this cavalry. Man, there was not a lack of effort here on Pugginton's part, and you can see just how dangerous cavalry is to the Skaven, because it's not like ODM Chosen One did a bad job protecting himself. He had the right units. He was fending off the cavalry as best he could. He did a really good job, obviously, because he won the battle, but I'm just showing this because this is how dangerous cavalry can be to the Skaven, and their units just don't cope well with cavalry charges unless it's something like a Council Guard, which is an unbreakable Storm Vermin with Halberd. It takes a lot. Now, obviously, I'm sure Teclis wished that he had been on his bird here, but of course that cost would have changed the army composition, and like I said, I don't know, maybe it's possible that Teclis on the bird was banned in this tournament. I have no idea exactly what rule they decided to go with. But I do like the pick of Teclis. He didn't bring it here, but he offers the potential for a net. The Chain Lightning, Fiery Convocation. Now, Fiery Convocation's a little more tricky to land. And Chain Lightning, too. Both of those have a pretty long spin-up time. And so you have to really get an opponent committed to a fight in order to be able to use those, or else they may be able to dodge. And there was a fair bit of dodging here by Chosen One. He did a nice job Now, obviously, Pugginton kept at it. He was able to get some kills with Teclis and do some damage. His archers took some damage, but most of them lived into the late game, were able to expend their ammo. It almost got rid of a hell pit, but, you know, again, that save they have gave him back all their hit points. You can see, again, the real challenge here. Skrulk is just barely touched, and the assassin's barely touched, and even with a bunch of units like Dragon Princes, will they eventually kill Skrulk? Well, yeah, if you have enough of them. And you can sit there and pound on him alone for long enough, but when you have those hell pits there, no. Because Skrulk will just ragdoll and avoid a lot of that damage and draw the fight out for a long time, and especially when you got something like the Rival Hide Talisman and the Assassin's Trophy, it's a real mess. It's difficult. I mean, Skaven, like I said, the High Elves certainly have some tools that should be frightening to Skaven, but Skaven have a lot of really interesting tools themselves. They have Howling Warp Gale. They can control the air with it if they decide to. I don't see that used a lot. Kind of surprised. But in this case, it's good that he didn't bring it, because the High Elves didn't bring anything in the air. But you got Howling Warp Gale, which can freeze flying units and let them get shot. They've got Warplock Jezails, which are fantastic against single entities or cavalry. Even good against infantry, for that matter. You've got Plague Clock Catapults, which provide excellent range that can help counter stuff like the Bolt Throwers. You've got Rat Ogres, which provide an element of speed and really nice armor-piercing damage for a unit that's honestly not super expensive with Rat Ogres, so they're pretty decent help against cavalry. And then you combine that with all kinds of chaff, which is kind of a strength and a weakness. It's a weakness in the sense that their infantry is absolute poopy. But because they have so much chaff, it can be useful because enemy units will have to cut through so much of it. It wears down their vigor. It makes it harder for those units to be in good fighting condition late in the game. And then Skrulk, of course, summoned in, what, 5-6 different units during this battle? So then that's, I mean, that's over 20, what it puts us up about, like 28 units or so, maybe more, that Pugginton would have had to have dealt with at that point because of how much Skrulk can summon. Now, granted, those units degrade. You don't necessarily have to kill them to the last one, but just saying, it's a problem. It's challenging. Well played by Chosen One. Man, what a series of games so far. These two players are really giving us a good show, and it's been fun to watch. I hope you all are enjoying it, too. I'm going to record Game 5, of course, and get that out to you, and check the links in the description if you want to go see a replay of the tournament as well. HeirofCarthage signing out for now.